Been in and out of tax trouble throughout a lucrative career. the single off Yerick's show on September 11th, 1985. It was career hit number 4,192. So, he was obviously very talented baseball player that he beat Ty Cobb's record. But this scandal was, I guess, the lasting image for his career. And so it's a little hard to see, but this one, it says, as the manager Rose watches his Cincinnati Reds take battle practice in 1988, and then this is Rose at a press conference in 1989, denying the charges of betting on baseball. So, I probably heard about this case in 2004, that's why I was thinking this was, you know, they were referring to something that had happened much earlier. But in any case, it's interesting because if you recall some of the other scandals that we've been talking about, quite a few of those had to do with games being rigged and major gambling, you know, by mafia and various other sources. Not only rigging those games, but then betting on them and making a lot of money and swindling a lot of people who were watching the games and believing in whatever the players were doing. Meanwhile, some of those players were paid off and maybe even took part in the betting. So, because of those early scandals, probably the baseball league and other leagues as well must have placed these laws, you know, in the forefront that no one should be betting on games, because it would encourage this sort of interference. You know, it would encourage either players being paid off or various other, you know, once you get into the gambling game, then the mafia and all of these other people start interfering. So, just even as a public statement, this sign was placed all over the place. Now, the thing is, most people, I don't know if I should say most people, a lot of people who watch sporting events bet on the games, like, you know, watching at home, people bet on the games, it makes it more interesting, you're more invested in whatever you're watching, because you've got, like, I don't know, 10 or 20 bucks riding on the game. Most people don't bet that much money. A lot of times it's just, you know, for their team to win or whatever it is, to give a little bit of excitement or incentive or what have you. So, that was a direct violation. I think if he had maybe bet on some other team, something that he had nothing to do with, let's say it was a basketball game or whatever, this probably would not have become any kind of an issue. Maybe somebody might have, brought it up in the press that, oh, okay, he's not supposed to be betting in general, but this is specifically about betting on your own team. And the reason that it's a problem is obvious. How does he know his own team is going to win? That kind of pushes the question, was there some sort of rigging going on that he was aware of, and maybe that's why he was betting, because he knew they were going to win or something like that. Like, it just opens up a whole can of worms that I think the commissioner or whomever wanted to close quickly. So by making him, I guess, the scapegoat or the public figure that everyone jumped on about the betting, and it just sort of opened up a debate as to whether betting or not betting was correct or a right thing to do. It quickly sidelined the bigger issue that maybe there was some rigging going on, and that's why he was betting, because he was betting on, how would he know his team is going to win? It's not like, maybe, I guess he was saying that he has so much confidence in his team, but he might have had other information. The fact that he has gambling issues and maybe thought it was a sure win, and he was, recovering money in an easy way. I think there are a lot of other questions that got sidelined because they were focusing on the right and wrong of betting, not really why he felt comfortable to bet, in the first place on his own team. And I don't know if that question's ever been answered. I've never read the book, this Costa Kennedy's book, but it was a bestseller, so maybe it addresses that issue. I'm not sure, but I do think that's kind of interesting that there was a reason that the story came out when it did. And I think it was maybe as a way to detract from the possible continued rigging of games. Like, maybe that never ended. According to a lot of sources, games are continued to be rigged, and they're rigged in a variety of very technological ways that people can't even, figure out. It's not in an obvious way, the way that they were done in the 1920s, when people were just getting paid off to miss a hit or something like that. Now it's done in a very different way, according to some sources. So, I'm not going to get into that right now. But anyway, I think that might be a possibility for this particular scandal coming out when it did, and the way that it became more of a national debate, and it sort of side skirts it sidelines some other points that I don't know if they were ever addressed or not, because I don't remember. I don't know the what was said in the press conferences, but I have a feeling that the focus was just on the betting and the right and wrong of betting, and they left it at that. And I guess he was an easy scapegoat as far as whether he should be in the Hall of Fame. I think most people, especially if there wasn't any kind of like drug use or, he won those games on his own merit, or he got those hits on his own merit, especially since most of those occurred before this scandal. I don't know, it kind of makes sense that he should at least be allowed within the Hall of Fame. At least, I mean, I do understand that perspective, that this particular scandal got him banned from future playing, but his past performance doesn't necessarily have to be negated. So I don't know. I guess they are going to reopen his case, or the new commissioner is going to open the case, Rob Mansfield, and reevaluate. So maybe after this much time, and since he also confessed, I guess maybe practicing for years, actually, for well over a decade. It's from 1989 till 2004. He wasn't even admitting that he betted. So, that might have been part of the reason, you know, that he wasn't admitting to it. And that may be why he wasn't